So I want to start off by outlining and talking about the purpose of why I decided to move into this space and start this program with Citizen Developer at Humana, and talk more on a personal note as we were going through. My whole career, I have been involved in healthcare delivery, and more personal, my wife is also a nurse practitioner, and she started practicing. I noticed that she would spend 7 or 8 hours out in the field working with patients and coming home exhausted, tired, and then she would spend another 4 or 5 hours documenting her patient's caseload. As I started outlining the Citizen Developer Program at Humana, I started asking, is Lauren's problem unique to Lauren? Or is that a problem that scales across our different healthcare segments? Which takes us back to Humana and why I enjoy working for this company as well, is everything that we do is to encourage the better health of our patients as we go forward, just like Lauren in the field and every other clinician as we go. And we do this by embedding challenging the status quo into our culture. Lauren shouldn't have to come home and sit there and hit her head against the table of why this is so manual and why she has to spend so much time not interacting with the patient, but just documenting it through multiple systems to make that happen. Just like every other company, we experience the same problems. We have architectures that are robust, that have barriers to change. So implementing a citizen developer or bringing the SME close to the development cycle seems like it creates a lot of risk. How do we start building the trust within the associates to start building and driving the better quality interaction with the members? By doing that, now the SMEs and their coworkers are developing these automations that are simple, repetitive steps, five or 10 steps within their process that they can get to market in 6 to 8 weeks as they're going. So how do we do this? How do we do this across different business segments as we go and align on problem statements? We did this by looking at our existing infrastructure. So we have quality audits, call recording, all these things that we innately had within our processes of continuous improvement. We rethought how we want to approach that. So as we were going across different business segments, we started categorizing the interaction. And within the interaction with the customer or patient, we realized that a majority of the time was spent doing clinical data management. And this was simply taking the, some cases, 70 or 80 steps that we were auditing within the process and categorizing them into 4 basic concepts. 3/4 of the time that the clinicians across programs were interacting was not talking to the member, but it was off the phone documenting that time, not talking with the actual customer. What this did for us was we always heard from everybody, I don't have enough time. This can't happen. You don't understand my problem. This was a common theme every time I would go do a side-by-side for discovery or talk to leadership. What this enabled us to do is now we have a unified problem that we can quantify across business segments, which isolated down into these 4 categories. Now we're able to develop our mission statement as we're looking. And how do we inspire these different groups, which may have competing strategies within the enterprise, to begin working together and unify the cause? So this is where using automation anywhere and embedding the citizen developer communities, we're using robotics to streamline patient care by streamlining repetitive tasks within a process. The key piece here is that we're not automating processes. We're automating steps within the existing process, which reinvent their job and approach. Since we live in such a dynamic environment with healthcare and regulation that's changing all the time, we're also rethinking how we're engaging our clinical products. So this enables us to do that quickly and adapt to changing cases. And then communication strategy. This was very important. We spent a lot of time going very deep into our communication strategy. The communication was, how does the frontline leader articulate this to their associates? Because the first thing they said when I presented this last year was, Joe, you're crazy, and what can I call my bot? And then educating our support organizations, our process teams, our compliance organizations, bring an awareness of now they have new ways to solve problems, and they need to embed those developer communities into that problem-solving process. Who owns digital transformation? Last year, about this time, I remember going to our IT partners, and I was like, let's break down the wall between business and IT. This program breaks down that wall. Compliance. I was surprised to know that compliance doesn't have a roadmap for many things. This program enabled us to ask them, how do we reduce the risk and the redundancy that we created over the years? Because now we can develop at less cost, and we can do it faster. The ROI that we saw with this program as we scaled this up in the last 6 months was for every $1 we spent, we saved $8 as we went through. So now that the development costs are much lower and we can deploy much quicker, we were able to deploy 34 automations with an 8-to-1 ROI in 6 months, while we scaled a team from 4 people to 46. Again, culture is the most important part of that, and that communication piece is critical, along with the frontline leaders that are supporting that journey and that transformation, and then all of the support groups that are around the table, not blocking, but adding catalysts to the event. Capture the right question. A lot of time along our journey, we tried to force technology to fit a problem. Automation was new. Deploying automation anywhere was new. So we thought we had to make it fit. Not the case. This enables the problem to fail and fail fast so we can adjust and pivot to the next thing. With our cycles not being 6 months or longer anymore and more like 6 weeks, it's okay to go down a 3-week path and shift and turn. Treat automation as a product. Every product has a purpose and every purpose has a life cycle. And as we look at that, these things don't have to be in place forever. In a lot of cases, we know automation is a bridge for a core system change or an enhancement downstream. Things to get out of this: build trust with your IT folks from the business side. Critical to success. There's a lot of times in the last year where I had all my chips on the table and it was a very uncomfortable position for me to put all the cards out there and let them see. And they did the same thing for me. But building that trust that transcended across projects and transformed into culture was critical. This program will make a big splash in your enterprise. From an ROI standpoint, from a customer engagement standpoint, associate standpoint, and making everybody rethink their processes and procedures that have been in place for so long. Make sure your culture enables that change. That will make it successful as we go. So that's it. Any questions?
Awesome. Thank you so much, Joe.